Good morning, students. Today we are doing an experiment for study the dependence of current on the potential difference across a resistor and determination of its resistance. In short, we call it as Ohm's law. Today we are doing Ohm's law. The entire thing is known as experiment number 5, the study the dependence of current on the potential difference across the resistor and determination of its resistance. In short, we call it as Ohm's law. Now, what are the things we need to do this Ohm's law? We have got the apparatus here. Can you see the apparatus? Okay, let me introduce the entire part of this apparatus. Okay, here, if we look at this, this is something called as milliammeter, which measures current. Here you can see that milliammeter has got some calibration, which I'm going to make you understand. Here, this is called as voltmeter, which measures potential difference. This is the resistance which is there, an unknown resistance which we want to find out how much is the value of this. This is where we are going to connect the battery. Okay, this is the battery eliminator, we call it as. It has got knobs. This knob is like how many volt battery you want to connect. This is by rotating you can connect it. Okay, this is going to be connected here. This is something called as rheostat. What is the rheostat does, everybody? Rheostat, through rheostat you can adjust current. If you want more current, you can adjust here. If you want less current, you can adjust here with the help of this rheostat. This is nothing but called a switch. So to switch on or switch off the circuit. Okay, so this is all about the apparatus. Now, we will learn how to find out the least count. Okay, if you look at this observation here, we have got there is something called as least count of the ammeter, least count of the voltmeter, zero error, and zero error of the voltmeter. So let us see how to calculate zero error or the least count. Okay, to understand that here, if I show you this milliammeter, okay, since here it's got ammeter, we will skip this ammeter, we will call it as milliammeter. Okay, we will find out the least count of this milliammeter. How to find out the least count, everybody? Just check it out here. Okay, if you look at this here, we have got a calibration, and if this calibration is shown, it is 0, 50, 100, 150, 200, and then it is 250. Now, 0 to 50, if you look at this, how many lines are there? So I start counting, it is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and 50th is the 10th line. So 0 to 50, we have got 10 lines. So here, what I'm going to write down here, check it out. Here, 10 lines stand for how many milliampere? It's going to be 50 milliampere. So if the 10 line is 50 milliampere, so the one line stands for how much? So we'll say question, this is question mark, x. So we'll cross multiply 10 into x is equals to 50 into 1. Finally, x is equals to 50 upon 10, and which comes out to be 5 milliampere. So children, the least count of this particular instrument for measuring current, milliampere, is 5 milliampere. This is how we find out. If I talk about the voltmeter, the same way we are supposed to do, children, look at this here. We have got the calibration 0, 2, 4, 6, 8, 10. So when I say 0, 2, 4, 6, 10, here if you look at this, 0 to 2, 10 lines are there. 2 to 4, 10 lines are there. Every two digits, we have got 10 lines in between. So how to find out the calibration? The same way how we have done it here. Means 10 lines stand for 2 volts. So here is 10 lines stand for 2 volt. So one line will stand for how many volt? So we'll cross multiply. It is going to be 10x is equals to 2 into 1. So x is equals to 2 upon 10, and that is going to be 0.2 volt. So how much is the least count of this? 0.2 volt. Okay. Now we will write down this. So let's quickly write down this. Let us start, students. Let's see the least count of the ammeter. As we calculated there, we find that the least count of the ammeter comes to. So we'll not call it as ammeter, we will call it as milliammeter. And this milliammeter, the least count came out to be 5 milliammeter. So 5, it is ampere, so you'll just substitute small m here. So it become 5 milliampere. Least count of the voltmeter we calculated there, and we found it as 0.2 volts. So it is going to be 0.2 volts. Now we are talking about the zero error.
What is zero error? If I look at this here, the milliammeter or voltmeter, I have to see this needle which is out there, it should be coinciding with the zero line. If it is exactly coinciding with the zero error, then we will say there is no zero error. But if it is below or above the zero, we will say there is a zero error. Here also you have to check, if it is coinciding with the zero, there is no zero error. But if it is above or the below to the zero, then we can call it as there is a zero error. So what we'll see is, just check, this needle is exactly coinciding with the zero here. So here is no zero error. So zero error of the milliammeter is dash, no zero error. So that we can write it as dash. If I look at this here, this is also exactly coinciding with the zero. So we can call it as, here is zero error of voltmeter. Again, nothing, we can put it as dash or zero. Now students, I'm going to show you how to connect the circuit and take the readings. So let's be ready. This is called as battery, and battery has got two ends, that is the red and the black terminals. We are going to connect two wires, one is a red wire, one is a black wire. This red wire is connected here to the red battery. Can you see this battery? So it is going to be connected to battery ka red, and this black is going to be connected to the black of this. So we have got only one connections to be made here for Ohm's law parameters. Only one connection. What is that, children? This is battery from here, red to red, and the black to black. No other connections. Please make sure no other connection need to be made here. Only red to red and black to black. Okay, one connection is made, and now the connection is over. We will start with the readings. How to start? Now you have to switch it on. The moment you switch it on, you will see this is glowing, means this is a battery eliminator is on. This show that it is glowing. I will keep it is written here is the battery is 8 volt. So what I do is, I will keep this eliminator on exactly 8 volt. So here it is on 8 volt. Now the maximum it can be 8 volt, so I'm keeping it at 8 volt. So I don't have to move it at all. So 8 volt is the final which I have kept it here. Now let us start taking the readings. How to take the reading? Now when you want to take the readings, you have to switch it on. So when you switch it on, here there is a switch, and the moment I switch on, you will see there is some deflection happening. Again, I switch on here. If it is off, there is no deflection. The moment I switch it on, you will see some deflection. Okay, so this deflection, let it be. What we are going to do is nothing but, with the help of rheostat, this is a rheostat. Now I'm going to adjust my 1 millimeter reading to some value. Okay, what we are going to do is, here in the journal, I'm going to show you the readings here. I am just going to write down here observed reading, your ammeter reading, which is going to be milliammeter. So what I do is, I will just jot down the readings. I want to select at 50 milliampere, then 100 milliampere, then it is 150 milliampere, and then it is 200 milliampere. These are the readings which I'm going to keep it on. Okay, and then I'm going to note down the corresponding voltmeter reading. So here it is 50 milliampere. So look at this here, with the help of rheostat, I'm adjusting this milliammeter on 50. So here is, look at this, it is moving, this needle is moving, and this needle is moving, and it is adjusted on 50. So this is on 50 now. And when you want to see this reading, you can only see perpendicular to surface. You have to be perpendicular to the surface, and then you see the reading. You cannot see the readings here or there. You have to adjust yourself perpendicular to this, and then the reading will be proper. So this is 50 milliampere. Now at the same time, I'm going to see what is the voltmeter reading. So if I check, what is voltmeter reading here is, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, sixth line it is on. So it is on sixth line. Each line stands for 0.2. So sixth line will be standing for how much? 1.2. 0.2 multiplied by 6. So that is going to be how much? 1.2. So this reading has become 1.2 volt. Now we will adjust this with the help of rheostat. We are going to adjust this on 100. Now the next. So 50, 100. I adjust it on 100. And now I'll see the reading. It is 2.1234. And this is the fifth. Now the reading is 3.
students, we will revise once again the reading for 50. So we will see that this is on 50. We will check the readings here in the voltmeter, and what we see is when the readings I check here, I find that 8th line
is coinciding.
Means 8th line multiplied by 0.2, the readings comes to 1.6. So instead of 1.2, I am going to write down my reading as 1.6. So there was little correction in this. So the reading is not 1.2, but then it is 1.6. And now what I do is, I just increase this 200 milliampere. So with the help of rheostat, I am going to increase this reading on 100 milliampere. So when I keep it on 100 milliampere, I check the reading here. This is 2. After 2, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5th and 6th line. It is 6th line coinciding. So if I say 6th line coinciding multiplied by 0.2, so it is going to be 1.2, and already 2 is there. So 2 plus 1, and this is going to be 3.2. So my next reading is going to be, for this is 3.2 volt. Okay, so my 100, the reading is 3.2. Now let's go for 150, students. So I adjust this on 150. When I adjust this on 150, I see that my reading is 4.2, 4.6 and 4.8. So my reading is 4.8. Fantastic. I'm getting the exactly correct reading. 4.8 volt, everybody. And then I go for my last reading, which is 200. Now look at this. It is not increasing about 200. So this is the last movement. What I can do is, I can increase the battery bit. So if I increase the battery bit, it goes till 200. So I've adjusted it on 200. And now I look at my reading. So my reading is 6. Here it is. The reading goes to 6.4 volt. Okay. This way we have finished with the readings. So this is all about how to take the readings. Okay. What did we do? We first adjusted the current, and then we noted the corresponding voltmeter reading. Again, I adjusted the next value of current. Again, I had noted down the next corresponding reading of that voltmeter. The next one and the next voltmeter reading, the next current reading here we adjusted, and we noted down the next voltmeter reading. And we have noted down the readings here. This is the current reading and this is the voltmeter readings. Okay, so my reading is done. Now what I do is, I need to have a little calculation. So let's do the calculation, everybody, here. This is 50 milliampere. So we don't need to do any corrections here. Let this column go like that. Here is the reading which is there of the voltmeter. It is in volts, but here it is milliampere and this is volt. This reading is not final. So what do we do is, we'll convert this, we'll make it the same. If it is milliampere, this should be millivolt. It cannot be in volt. So we will multiply by 1000, because to convert from volt to millivolt, we have to multiply by 1000. So we will do that. We'll multiply by 1000, and this reading has become 1600 millivolt. This has become 3200 millivolt, and this has become 4800 millivolt, and this has become 6400 millivolt. So you saw that I've converted all these readings in millivolt. Now what I have to do next is, here look at this formula, R is equals to V upon I. So this is my corrected reading, and here this is the observed and the corrected is the same. What we have to do is, we have to just divide. So what I'm going to do is, now next is, R is equals to here. So this is my corrected 1600 divided by 50. So R is equals to 1600 divided by 50. So 0002. Now we'll divide this. 5 ones are, 5 twos are, 5 threes are 15, 5 twos are. So I got my reading as 32 ohm. This is my reading. Now next one I divide. So R is equals to here, 3200 divided by 100, because my ammeter, milliammeter reading is 100. So 0002, my reading is how much? Again 32 ohm. Here the next one, 4800 divided by, and the reading is 150. When you divide it, again you get 32 ohm. If next one 6400, again you divide by 200. 2 1s are 2 2s, 2 3s are 6, 2 2s are 4. So again I got as 32 ohm. What I notice is here is resistance V upon I is equals to constant I should get, and I am getting all the readings as constant, that is 32 32 32, which says that this R is equals to constant. What is Ohm's law? Ohm's law says that V upon I, that is the R ka value, should always remain constant. If I don't change the length, area of cross section, material and temperature, okay, of the conductor, I should be getting the same value. So you can see that I am getting the same value as 32, 32 and 32, which says that my unknown resistance is of 32 ohm. So let's mean value of the resistance, this is 32, so it is going to be 32 only. And the value of unknown resistance is, again I have calculated and I found that it is 32 ohm. So finally what I noticed is the unknown value of the resistance is how much? 32 ohm. So children, this completes our first experiment, that is Ohm's law. Okay, this is how we have to do Ohm's law, children. Now when you see this video, please go through this video nicely and note down each and every points correctly and write down, make a note of it, and so you will remember it for life and you will not forget this for the exam. Thank you so much. We'll meet for the next practical. Thank you.